Yo, what's good, y'all? This is Ikechi Onyenika, and I'm about to head over to the Melanie Fiona concert. It's going to be lit. They've got Jacqueline Constance, Spanky, and Aaron Camper opening up for her, so I'm really excited for that. I'm really looking forward to listening to Melanie Fiona's music. I'm just trying to get inspired. I'm also trying to analyze what the band's doing, you know, and learn as much as I can from that aspect. So I'm definitely going for some knowledge, you know. And just to have a good time too, you know, because sometimes music can heal. So sometimes I'm just looking for deeper meanings for certain artists and their songs and their kind of style and their music. And a lot of music has different stories, you know. Everyone's a storyteller in some kind of way. So I'm definitely looking forward to today's performance. Right now I'm waiting for my Uber, so I'm just gonna wait. I'm getting, you know, my things ready. And we're about to head out, so I will let you guys know what my final reactions for this concert is once I get back. Alright, y'all. See you in a bit.
Thank you. nigga put out last year. Check it out. When we started out, it was just without understanding. Cause we had no plans, man. It was just romantic. Yeah.
Over the seas, all the breeze. Crazy if you think I'll stay, boy, I'll be on the next one. real ones who know songs that ain't even out yet. So, those are the real ones.
Let's get it poppin'.
Those that have been with me from the first album, The Bridge.
The Bridge!
Those that crossed the bridge with me to the MF Life. Yeah. And now everybody in this room is invited to Boy, The Next Train, which is my new album coming out later this year.
Yeah.
Show before, maybe you are familiar with some of my music.
Hello.
You know, there's one thing that I love to sing about. It is.
But these niggas ain't shit, okay?
But I do also feel that love is a journey, and so is life. So this new album is all about moving forward. It's all about the journey moving, because I feel like if you're not on the train, you're on the tracks.
Hello.
I've been on the tracks since 2018. It's all about progress. So, being that it was Valentine's Day yesterday, shout out to all the lovers in the house. I need to know there's more lovers in the house for this next song, because I dedicate this to the lovers. Let's go on a little journey tonight. Let's start at the top. When you fall in love, when you find yourself doing things for that special somebody that you might not normally do, and all your friends are looking at you like, damn,
come on, bro.
But you know what? You just gotta block out the haters. You gotta turn to your baby and say, baby, I'm a fool for you.
Feelings such as a love.
All right, y'all. So I just got back from the concert. It was honestly amazing. The crowd really loved it too. And the funny thing about the Ardmore Music Hall, because I was thinking like once I got inside, it would be more of the same of Tower Theater. It's not really like a theater per se. It is a theater, but like, they don't have like rows of seats and stuff that you can sit in for audience members. There is a balcony area, but I think that's for like VIP or like people that the main artists, you know, their main people can stay. The venue was awesome. That was my first time going inside that venue. It was awesome. I ordered some food. I got my favorite, as y'all know, the bacon cheeseburger. I didn't get the fries this time though. Because tell me how a venue's not going to have fries. How do you not have fries? Y'all are going to be asking me, oh, do you want tater tots? You want tater tots? Like, come on, y'all. I don't want tater tots. I want my French fries. Y'all know me. I love French fries. But other than that, you know, the burger was okay. I got a Shirley Temple with that. Other than that, the music, you know, Spanky's group killed it. Jacqueline Constance, she was with, she performed with Spanky, so, you know, that was actually really cool to see. Other than that, Aaron Camper's group was cool. I got to talk to the bassist. He was cool people. You know, also got to talk to the drummer. Funny enough, I actually played with him at the Parkside jam session. So y'all can check that out. The link will be up above. And yeah, that was a pretty lit time. But overall, they killed it. And as for Melanie Fiona, everybody was looking forward to that performance. She definitely delivered. There was a technical hiccup that happened in the middle, or like actually in the beginning, but you know, she was professional. I liked how she was interacting with the crowd during that time and letting the audience members sing. So that was pretty lit to see. I wish I was in that front row, but I just wish I knew all of her songs, like the lyrics and everything. I definitely would have gone for that, because you never know. You never know what can happen afterwards. But overall, it was a lit performance. If you like this video, please make sure to rate, comment, share, and subscribe. Let me know in the comment section what other videos you want me to do, if you want to see more concert visits from me. Also, make sure to click the notification bell so you know as soon as my next video comes out. Also, make sure to follow me on my social media. Links will be down below in the description, and I'll leave an end slide at the end of this video. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Peace!